Welcome everyone. Today I would like to explain Ansible and its installation on CentOS 7. Guys, Ansible is very useful and nowadays many IT and telecom companies are using Ansible to automate their complex tasks. There is some important point on Ansible which you should know. Ansible is a simple IT automation tool that automates cloud provisioning, configuration management, application deployment, infraservices orchestration, and many other IT needs. Ansible works by connecting to your nodes and pushing out the small programs called Ansible module. Ansible is easy to deploy and most importantly, it uses a very small language that is YAML in the form of Ansible playbook that allow you to describe your automation jobs in a plain or a simple English. Root login are not mandatory. You can log in as any user and then you can sudo to that user, right? Ansible authorized key module is a great way to use Ansible to control host. You can also use user authentications like Kerberos, LDAP or identity management system. Right, let's make it more simple. Have a look on Ansible workflow. So guys, Ansible has two major components. The first one is playbook and the second one is inventory. Playbook contains task and module, whatever you want to run on these hosts. Inventory has this host information in the form of IP addresses. You can simply categorize your inventory as per your requirement. Suppose you want to install Apache on host 1, you can put this host in group A. And if you want to install DNS, DHCP on other host, you can create another group and put these hosts inside that group, say group B, right? In order to perform tasks, your Ansible should communicate with these hosts via SSH. You will also have to make your Ansible passwordless. So you can do this by copying the SSH authorization key from your Ansible server to these hosts. Once the communication is established between Ansible and the host, you can fire any command, you can create any playbook and perform your task as per your requirement. Now we will come to know why Ansible is important. We have two scenarios: with Ansible, without Ansible. First, with Ansible, we will try to find out total time taken by Ansible to run a single command, that is disk utilization DF, on 1000 host. So Ansible took 2 seconds to run a single command on one host. So there are 1000 hosts. The total time taken to run on 1000 host will be 2000 seconds. If you convert these 2000 seconds into minutes, you will get 33 minutes. And if you again convert this 33 minutes into hours, that is more than half an hour, right? And now we'll take without Ansible scenario. So total time taken by a user to run a single command DF on 1000 hosts. Suppose a local user took 3 minutes to log into the system and run a single command. So for 1000 hosts, it will take around 3000 minutes. If you convert this 3000 minutes into hours, it will be around 50 hours, and once you again convert these hours into days, it will be more than 2 days. And your Ansible staking for the same task is around half an hour. Now you can think why Ansible is on high demand in any IT industry and organization. So before installing Ansible, we'll have to look on the prerequisite. So the Ansible should be reachable to the host, and it's able to connect to and control the Ansible host over SSH. Now it's time to install Ansible and make it passwordless for other hosts. So friends, log in into your CentOS machine and start installing Ansible server. Guys, to install Ansible, we will follow these 6 steps. First, to install EPL repository, that is extra package for enterprise Linux. Second, to install Ansible packages. Third, to generate SSH key pair. Fourth, to copy public key into target slash host servers. Fifth, to configure Ansible host in slash vi slash etc ansible slash host. And the last, to connect host machine using Ansible. Guys, we have 3 servers. First, where we will install Ansible, and these 2 are the host server or the target server where we will perform our task. Let's start installing Ansible. So guys, I have changed the host name so that it will be clear that this is my Ansible server. Let's start yum install epl hyphen release. Okay, star hyphen y to say yes, right? It will start installing all the extra packages. It will take some time. Successfully installed EPL packages. Just clear it. Now we will install Ansible packages through yum. You can use yum command, yum install Ansible star. It will install all the Ansible packages. Say hyphen y to yes and enter. So guys, this server is directly connected to internet, so it will go to the internet and download Ansible packages for me. If you are in production environment, then you will have to create a local repo, or you can do one thing, you can download Ansible RPM packages from your desktop or from any internet connected system, and you can use RPM command and install the RPM packages. We have installed Ansible successfully. Now we'll check Ansible version. So use command Ansible hyphen hyphen version. So we are using 2.921, right? You can also check its packages RPM hyphen QA pipe grab Ansible, right? So we have these packages. Now I will create SSH key. So we will generate one key, SSH key gen, right? And we will copy this key to the host, right? Enter and type Y. And again enter, then press enter. So this is your public SSH key. Now we'll copy this generated SSH key to the host server. So use SSH copy ID and then user at the rate IP address of your host machine, right? 43.10. This is my first machine. It will ask you the password of that machine. You can use the password and see one pop key is added, right? Similarly, I will copy this key to the second host. Use the IP of the second host, say yes, and type the password of that host. See, we have copied our SSH public key of this Ansible server to both of the host. We will try to log in to both host server without password. So use SSH root at the rate 192.168.43.10. That is the first host. See, we are able to log in without the password, right? And now I will try to log into the second host. So use second host IP and see, I am able to log into the second host as well. Now we have successfully completed our connectivity between our Ansible server to the target server. Now we'll perform our task. Clear your screen. Go back to your Ansible server, exit from here. Now we are at Ansible server. Now we'll go to the inventory files. So use Ansible host file, right? And you have to create your group by entering the host. So insert and use, you can write anything, test server or host, test server, okay, test server. And you have to enter the IP address of both the host machine. So enter IP address 192.168.43.10, then enter the second host 192.168.43.20, and this is, you are done. Just save the file. Now we will try to ping both host server from this Ansible server. Use Ansible hyphen m ping all. So it will check all the host which is configured in this host file, and see we have entered these two IP address, which is our host, and it is successfully pinging. You can see the message 192.168.43.20 successfully pinging. So we'll get this response, ping pong, right? It's pinging. Now for the second host, you can see 192.168.43.10. This is also successful and it is also pinging, right? You can also use, instead of all, you can use your group name, and that is test server, right? See, this will check for your test server. So we have entered these two hosts and we have successfully pinged through Ansible. Like that, you can enter any command and get the output from n number of hosts. So currently I have added two hosts. You can use 10 hosts, 20 hosts, 100 hosts, and you can run simply one command and get output from all the hosts at a time. As we have seen how Ansible automation is important. In next video, we will run multiple commands from this Ansible server on these hosts and check the status. We'll also try to run playbook. Thanks for watching the video.